Today we do a complete review and test of the K40 Chinese laser cutter after we've been using it for about a year. This video has four sections. In the first one, we run a few tests and talk about what you can expect from the K40 laser. In the second section, we take a look at the safety issues and how to overcome them. The third section is about features the K40 is missing in comparison to other models, such as the Glowforge or a full spectrum laser. The fourth and last section closes with our recommendation. What can you cut with the K40? The laser is able to cut quite detailed patterns in paper. The main issue when cutting paper is that you have to move the laser fast, which creates wiggly lines if you cut very fine details. Cardboard is easier than paper, as you can cut slower without lighting your workpiece on fire. We will link in the description to videos with more example projects. The laser can cut 3mm MDF without problems. MDF cuts quite differently depending on the glue that has been used, so try out a sample before you order a full sheet of MDF. Plywood can be cut up to 5mm if it's a rather soft plywood and not as dense as Baltic birch. Of course, you can engrave plywood, MDF and all other kinds of woods. The ability to cut acrylic was a real game changer for us. The laser cuts 5mm acrylic without problems, and you can also engrave patterns or text. You can engrave glass, and while you can't cut it, the laser can score a line along which you can break the glass. When it comes to metal, you can engrave some metals as aluminium when covering it with a lubricant that contains molybdenum. And you can powder coat or paint metal and then remove the paint with the laser. The K40 can cut and engrave quite a few more things, such as linoleum for stamps and a lot of other things. But now let's have a look at the dark side, safety issues. Out of the box, the K40 is a perfect tool to destroy your eyesight, kill you by an electric shock and burn down your house. Let's go through these one by one. It is very tempting to open the lid while the laser is running, be it for moving stuff out of the way or to take pictures. If the laser beam is reflected in a bad way and hits your eye, you will go blind immediately. You should not only fix this by getting proper safety glasses, but also build a safety switch into the K40. We have a step-by-step video on how to wire a switch into the laser. The next way the laser cutter can kill you is by an electric shock. All metal housings should be grounded so that when a hot wire gets in contact with the case, it creates a short circuit. The Chinese manufacturers isolate the ground cable very well with paint. So when a wire gets loose and you touch the casing, your body becomes the grounding wire, which could kill you. In our setup video, we show how to fix this with a bit of sandpaper. The last major safety issue is that the laser sets the material on fire, which is exactly what we want to engrave, for example, wood. Most laser cutters have a device called an air assist that extinguishes the flame by a constant airflow. Without an air assist, wood or cardboard will burn. We have a video on how to 3D print a cheap air assist solution that is working great for us. With these safety issues fixed, there are still a few features that you would get from, for example, a Glowforge that the K40 doesn't offer. Let's have a look at the differences. The K40 comes with a dysfunctional bed that can't be adjusted in height. Luckily, the bed on the K40 is easy to replace, and we have a video on how to install a replacement. The cooling of the K40 works well if you use the laser for half an hour or so. When running the laser over an extended period of time, the water gets hot and the cooling is no longer working properly. We are currently working on a fix for that. A video on an improved cooling system should be up soon. We also replaced the plastic tube for the air exhaust with a metal one. The Glowforge has a nice air filter as an accessory that you can use in order to use the machine indoors. This might be a topic for a future video on how to build something similar in a DIY fashion for the K40. Lastly, some of the other laser cutters have a camera that helps you to align the pattern on the workpiece. While it's not impossible to implement such a feature, we would not have much use for it. The same goes for a rotary attachment, which you can get for the K40 for around $250 from a third-party supplier. Which brings us to the summary. Would we buy the K40 laser again? Yes, we are happy with the laser, and if you think about it, you can buy around 10 K40 lasers for the price of a single Glowforge or a full spectrum laser. Is a China laser also the right laser for you? This question is a little more difficult to answer. You should look at the K40 not as a ready-made product that you can switch on and it starts to produce stuff. Rather consider it as a kit and a starting point. If you know how to use a multimeter, a soldering iron, if you have a 3D printer or are able to talk the nice guy from your local makerspace into printing you an air assist, go for it. If you watch the videos about the basic safety improvements and feel totally scared, watch them again. If that doesn't help, you should probably not buy a K40. Using it without modifications is quite dangerous, and a few thousand bucks is cheap if it helps you to stay alive. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe for more laser and other making related videos, and follow us on Instagram for a look at future projects.